Good morning, class. Hope you all are healthy and fine. See, that day we learned a new word, that is mayhem. Mayhem means chaos. Similarly, on the basis of that, I had given you some homework in your literature book. So I am here to discuss all the answers with you people. Let's see what is happening in this. See, signboard. What is the synonym of signboard? Banner. Fulfill. What is the synonym of fulfill? Yes, achieve. Price, what is the synonym of price? That is cost. Reward, prize. Terrified, frightened. Handsomely, it is generously. Now let's see what will be the answer of these fill-ups. The terrified man started crying. One who will be very scared will start crying. So this happened here. This shirt range in price. I have not written here, but what is the answer? Price from rupees 300 to over 1000. She finally fulfilled her ambition of becoming a scuba diver. Nena has been rewarded handsomely for saving the life of three children. There is a reward of 10,000 for finding the lady's diamond necklace. There is a signboard of no parking here. Kindly park your car over there. So these are the answers. Then I had given you another exercise where you were supposed to put proper punctuation marks, and as well as you people have to write that what kind of sentence is it. See, first one is already done. We wear cotton clothes in summer. It was exclamatory mark given. We need, because it has a subject, it has a verb. So we need to put what? We need to put a full stop, and it is assertive sentence. Okay. Please switch on the fan. Fan. Please, it is an imperative sentence starting with switch, and you is the implied subject. It is hidden. So it is an imperative sentence. And what punctuation mark do we put in punctuation mark? See, in imperative sentence, we put a full stop. So what will come here? Full stop. Okay, so what kind of sentence is this? Imperative sentence. Now, do you like eating mangoes? Now, do you like eating mangoes? It is a question statement, a question, okay? So, it is an interrogative sentence. What we will put here? Question mark. See, what have I written? Interrogative. Okay? I don't like pizza and burgers. So, I don't like. Now, here, an exclamatory mark is written. Now, what will come here? I subject, don't like, verb is also given. So, object is also, so it is a sentence, not an exclamatory mark. What come, will come here? What will come here? Full stop will come here. So, it is what kind of sentence? You can write on declarative or statement or assertive. Any one thing you can write down here. What a beautiful bird that is. Now, again here, question mark will not come. Though it is starting with what, but it is showing surprise, not asking a question. Because if it had been a question, there would be a verb just after what. What is that bird? Okay, then it would be question interrogative. But here it is an exclamatory sentence. So here will be exclamatory mark. See what have I written? Exclamatory sentence. Now, where has she gone? Now, see here, W, it is starting with W. Where? Here, exclamatory mark is put in the book. But we, after where, what is there? Verb is given. So, it is what kind of sentence? It is an interrogative sentence. Don't open the cupboard. Now, here, exclamatory mark will not come. It is again, don't open. U is implied subject. U is hidden. Here will be full stop. It is an imperative sentence. In the next exercise, you were supposed to put correct punctuation marks. See, Abir, have you been to Amer Fort? It is a question. So, question mark. No, please tell me all about it. It is an imperative sentence. So, what will come here? Full stop. You must go there, Rhea. Full stop. Such a majestic fort. It is! Exclamatory mark. It is located on a hill and is a major tourist attraction. Then, full stop. Rhea, I read long ago that there is a lake nearby the fort. Full stop. Is this lake the main source of water for the fort? Question mark. Abhi, yes, you are right, Rhea. Full stop. Rhea, what is its name? Question mark. Abhi, it is called the Mauta Lake. And then it will come full stop. So, understood? Let's put correct punctuation mark. Now, these answers may vary. See what have I written? Has Mohit finished his work? Starting with has. So, I have made an interrogative sentence. Amrita is learning her lessons. What a beautiful flower! Exclamatory mark. Please don't disturb me. Is the tiger running after the deer? Question mark. Salim can sing well. Ouch! I have hurt my knee! Exclamatory mark. Because ouch is an interjection. Ask him to meet me. Full stop again. Implied subject. No. Subject is given imperative sentence. Now next I had given you that this you people had to do on Sunday. So that much homework was to do to be done on Saturday. And this was for Sunday. Now see pass. Pass is both noun and verb. I told you how it is a noun or verb. Like we went to Rohtang Pass. Here pass is a noun. Could you please pass me your pencil? Here it is what? It is a verb. Sign. Now sign is again both the things. Noun also, verb also. Like put your sign here. Signature. Okay. Put your sign here. Then it is a noun. Hana? Then sign here. If we say sign here, then it is verb. Okay. Another example. I have put a signboard outside my house. Okay. So it is what? Noun. I am signing a checkbook. Okay, so then it is a verb. Sell. Sell is what? Both. It is a noun also. It is a verb also. Okay. Where it can be a verb in, only in the form of gerund. Like selling is sell. Selling is going... For example, first you see the verb, like the shopkeeper sells the things on very high prices. Okay, now selling is organized by the shopkeeper. Okay, so here it is what? Selling is a noun. Or selling has been organized by the shopkeeper. Suspicion is a noun. I have suspicion on him. Steal. Steal is both verb also, steal is both noun also. Like suppose the thief has stolen my watch. Here steal is what? Verb. Okay. Now something you get in a very less price. Like suppose you go to market, you find a jacket and you think that it would be for 5,000 rupees. And when you go near to it and you see the tag, price tag, and you find that it is just for 1,500 rupees. You find it is so cheap. Means it is not very costly. It is offered, the offer is in a very, the shopkeeper is offering this jacket in a very less price. So it is a kind of steal. Okay. So you purchase that, you did not even purchase this jacket, you got it in steal. Okay. So this way it is, steal is a noun. Luck, again luck can be a noun also, luck can be a verb also. Punish. Punish is verb only, that the teacher punished us. Inform, again it is only a verb, that she informed me about the new class or about the online class. Clear? Now see, enough, another word is tough, and laugh. Hope you people have also written some of the words. Bow, plow, slow. Okay, see. We were supposed to write words that end with O-U-G-H and have sound of F or O. Okay. So, we have got the words like that. Next, I had given you one story. Hope you all have pasted a page properly and written. Like, I have written a story. When I grow up, I want to be a pilot. A pilot can fly in the sky with their aeroplane. It must be great to fly a plane above the clouds. I want to see what it looks like in the sky with only clouds for company. As a pilot, I would be able to travel to different places as well as fly over rivers, mountains, and valleys. To be able to be a pilot, though, I will have to learn to read the map to know where I am. I study, it's a study must, I study its study must be an exciting and I will be living a good life of a pilot. Okay, so this way you need to write what a composition.